just 33 days to go now until the election, and we are counting down to one of the most anticipated vice presidential debates in political history.
And the outcome of the November election may depend on voter registration and just how many voters turn out to vote. Recent voter registration drives have been shattering records, and the unprecedented effort to get out the vote could make all the difference.
And Margaret Johnson joins us now live with our big story at 6 o'clock. Margaret?
Well, Cameron and Wanda, from the young to the old, if they're not registered, they're certainly doing it now. Who are they? What it could mean for the candidates, plus what some people are willing to do to make sure those voters go to the polls.
Well, it's a chance to make some history, for one thing, you know, one way or the other.
51-year-old Michael Clark, one of the 20,000 new registered voters just in Forsyth County since last year.
The status quo's got to go. I mean, the trickle-down ain't working.
We caught up with him at the Urban League, registering to vote for the general election, now 5 weeks away. He's ready for change.
I want the war to ease. I want the war to, you know, I want us to get out of that. I want the economy to have an upturn. I want the prices to go down. I want everybody to have a chance to own a home. So I lost mine.
North Carolina has registered a record 600,000 new voters since the last presidential election, bringing the total voters to 6 million, most of them young Democrats, 18 to 24.
The state is getting a lot of attention.
Urban League President Keith Granberry says interest is phenomenal.
It's so many people, black, white, Hispanic, you name it, they've come through these doors to register to vote.
But what does it all mean for presidential candidates John McCain and Barack Obama when you consider North Carolina hasn't put a Democrat in the White House since Jimmy Carter in 76? And Democrats outnumber Republicans at the ballot box in the Tar Heel State.
And historically, that's a tough deficit for one party to overcome just in the space of 4 years. He's essentially banking that he can hold North Carolina based on historical voting patterns. But the Obama camp is really kind of putting its best foot forward and saying we hope to at least make it competitive and perhaps we can pull off an upset.
The question now, will they follow through and go to the polls? The Urban League is part of a statewide nonpartisan effort to call up every single new voter, even providing them a ride to the polls. Like Tommy Lee Jones in the blockbuster movie The Fugitive, they plan to go wherever is necessary to get their voter.
What about the outhouse and the
we'll
hen
house? We'll go to the outhouse, we'll go to the hen house, we'll go to anywhere you need us to go. If you call us and you need a ride, we'll provide that ride for you.
Well, we mentioned 20,000 new voters just in Forsyth County. Guilford County has registered over 22,000. All indications that North Carolina could be a huge player in this election. Back to you.